Gennady Golovkin has been out of the ring since his victory over Sergiy Derevyanchenko in October 2019, but he will be back under the lights before 2020 is over for a clash against unbeaten Polish fighter Kamil Szeremeta.
21st defense of Gennady Golovkin's world middleweight title.
Golovkin, a modern-day boxing legend, is still rebuilding his career following his two grueling clashes with Canelo Alvarez.
Triple G walks right through.
A trilogy fight against the Mexican could yet be on the cards at a later date, but Golovkin will not be overlooking his bout with Szeremeta this week.
I too believe that it will be a big drama show.
Szeremeta has won all 21 of his pro fights to date and was last in action on the undercard for Golovkin Derevyanchenko as he saw off Oscar Cortez.
I'm prepared for the best version of Golovkin.
But before Triple G returns to the ring against Szeremeta this weekend, Boxing Extra predict how things will go down in the center of the ring on fight night. Golovkin is one of the most impressive boxers of this generation.
A knockout machine.
Triple G has made a name for himself by punishing opponents in the ring. Although he was only able to claim a silver medal at the 2004 Summer Olympics in Athens, he has repeatedly shown that he has unparalleled power for a boxer his size. It only took 3 years for Golovkin to receive his first major title fight. He was 18-0 when he faced Milton Nunes for the WBA interim middleweight title in Panama City. He won the official title 4 months later with a third-round KO of Nilson Julio Tapia. That began a dizzying ascent for Triple G. He added the IBO middleweight belt with a first-round KO of LeJuan Simon, and he defended those two belts 8 straight times with knockouts in the 8th round or earlier. Golovkin tacked on the WBC title against Marco Antonio Rubio, and he fully unified the middleweight division against David Lemieux in October 2015.
We don't know if he is great until he gets in the ring with another top fighter.
Although he has a draw and a loss to Alvarez, Golovkin should have at least a win and a loss, if not for some questionable judging decisions. Triple G is widely seen to have won the first fight against Alvarez, although he was given a draw, and his majority decision loss in the rematch was a bit of a head-scratcher too.
We really could have had another draw.
However, that hasn't stopped him from looking impressive against his other foes. Golovkin reclaimed the IBF and IBO middleweight belts last October in Madison Square Garden against Sergiy Derevyanchenko.
I'm ready to Canelo, just bring him, just ask him, I'm ready, today I stay here.
However, it wasn't his best performance. He won a narrow unanimous decision and didn't have the same power that has defined his career. Szeremeta is currently unbeaten. He wasn't a hyped amateur, but he has carved a path to become a top middleweight. Szeremeta won the vacant European middleweight belt in February 2018 and retained the title twice. For most of his career, Szeremeta hasn't had knockout power. However, that has changed in his recent fights. Szeremeta has secured 3 of his last 5 wins without needing to go to the scorecards. Golovkin returns to the ring for the first time in over a year on Friday against undefeated Polish middleweight contender. At 38 years old, Golovkin may be a little slower and a little less effective than he once was, but the talk of his decline is way overblown. As narrow as his 2019 decision win over Derevyanchenko was, he still has the skill and concussive power to nuke pretty much anybody, particularly somebody like Szeremeta. Golovkin is one of the most accomplished middleweight boxing champions in history, and his opponent appears to be a 31-year-old with a glossy record and regional-level credentials intended to help Triple G look more like the menace he once was than he probably is. Last time out against a durable contender with elite skills in Sergiy Derevyanchenko, Golovkin didn't look like the fighter most people considered one of the scariest punchers in 160-pound history. Instead, Derevyanchenko appeared to get stronger as the fight progressed, and Golovkin had to settle with escaping with a close victory on the scorecards in a fight that could have gone either way. Golovkin has been trying to get the third clash with Alvarez since winding up on the receiving end of a controversial 12-round majority decision in their rematch in September 2018.
How confident are you that we will see a third fight between Golovkin and Canelo?
There's no doubt whatsoever.
Golovkin says he's tired of waiting around for a trilogy match against Canelo Alvarez, and he now suspects that they'll never fight him again. Golovkin wants fans to know that he is not the one that is keeping the third fight with Canelo from happening. Indeed, Canelo has been putting off the third clash with Golovkin, even though the fans wanted it. For whatever reason, Canelo hasn't fancied another fight with Golovkin. Alvarez obviously knows how hard the fight would be, and he might feel it's better to live with a controversial win rather than temperate by fighting Triple G again and possibly lose by knockout. Golovkin has been working on improving his power, which is a good idea because his hand speed is obviously not improving. If Golovkin can get a little more power, it will help him bludgeon his opposition. So it really seems like Golovkin's handlers are pitting him against Szeremeta so that the fighter can wreck somebody like the old days. Szeremeta hasn't competed at the world level before, and even on his regional circuit, he is not much of a puncher.
My victory, it will be not only one of the biggest victory in Polish boxing, but in Polish sport.
We expect Golovkin to win well and look good against an opponent in deep water after no test or bridge to this elite level.
Big drama show returns. It's power, man. People love knockouts.
There is no opponent remotely close to the quality of Golovkin, even at this stage of his career. And the year out for the Kazakh of a punishing 12 rounds with Derevyanchenko will have done him the world of good.